Good day, fellow investors. Now, most of the news is around Apple, Amazon, Tesla, and all those kind of stocks. So one might think value investing is dead. Nobody wants to talk about value investing. If you look at the performance, the Russell 1000 value is up 43%, while the Russell Growth Index is up 111%. So that's a huge difference over 10 years. So with such an underperformance, it's crazy to call oneself a value investor now. All value investors, we should close ourselves in our closets and never come out again. Nevertheless, let's see what value investing is. As Buffett would say, the essence of value investing is buying stocks at less than their intrinsic value. So practically, you try to buy a dollar for less, 80 cents, 50 cents, as low as you can. This is very difficult because the S&P 500 price to book value is 3.23. So here you're paying $3.23 to buy $1. The CAPE ratio was 15 in 2009, now it's 30.34. This shows that fundamentals earnings didn't improve, just stock prices went up. To move myself from always looking at earnings, here is the price to revenue ratio. It was below 1 in 2009 and now it's above 2.5. This means that S&P 500 revenues didn't grow while the stock prices increased exponentially. Now what's left for the value investor? Stay in cash, look for options around the world, what we are doing on this channel, or become a growth investor. I wouldn't go for the growth investor because you can see here that at current market valuations, the future corrections have always been above 25% and up to 50%. They could probably be even larger when a correction starts. So if you are a value investor, I wouldn't go into growth stocks now. The second option I told you can be to wait in cash. Buffett has $99.7 billion in cash on the balance sheet and he's patiently waiting for investment opportunities. So that's a very interesting option and a very smart option to do. So simply wait, do nothing, enjoy your life and wait for opportunities to knock on your door. They will certainly come, especially with the huge expected correction that will eventually come. When? I don't know, but it will be there. So if you have cash and everybody's making money on the S&P 500, you obviously underperform. Nevertheless, check what Seth Klarman did from 1991 till 2000. If we start with $50,000, after 10 years with Seth Klarman, it would be $131,000. But the S&P 500 would be almost double at $237,000. So even Seth Klarman, one of the most famous investors now in the world, he underperformed the S&P 500 for more than 5-6 years in a row. So that's a huge time to underperform. Many would close down shop, people would take their money away. Nevertheless, in the long term, he beat the S&P 500 by double. So his returns have been better even with 6 years of underperformance. So value investing is certainly not dead. It is dead only when people think about, usually just before the next crash comes. In the 1990s, value investing was dead because everybody was investing in crazy internet companies. 1980s, we had corporate takeovers. 1970s, the Nifty 50 stocks. 1700s, the South Sea Company, tulip bulbs in the 1600s, and all those crazy investments. Eventually, they all revert to the mean. When? I don't know. Do I sound crazy when I talk like this? Yes, to 99% of the investing population. What can I do? I'm a value investor. Nevertheless, value investing is still here. All those fads are dead. Value investing continues and is always the power that leads to the highest returns in the long term. Do you agree with me? Maybe not, maybe well. I'm looking forward to your comments in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Click like if you like the content. Subscribe if you haven't, and I'll see you in the next video.